Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. A really great brunch always has very good sausage. My recipe for lamb sausage served with a side of Johnnycakes will surely make you flip. Let's get started. I'm going to start with about a teaspoon of salt, and I'm going to make a little spice rub. Ground lamb actually is really acceptable to very highly seasoned foods. So I put the salt in with a little paprika, a mixture of ground rosemary, thyme, and basil. I'm going to put a teaspoon of ground garlic powder. This way it really blends in well with the meat. And then a tablespoon of fresh chopped parsley. And to that I'll add in some fresh chopped green onion or scallion, which really gives it a bit of a zing into the patty. So the first thing I want to do is come to the lamb or the chopped meat. Anytime you're making sausage, hamburgers even, you want to make sure your chopped meat is really, really cold. Sometimes you can even ice up the bowl ahead, put it in the fridge or even the freezer, and make sure it's very, very cold. That's going to help the binding of the patties or the sausage in this case. I'll add in one fresh egg. I made a little well inside. And then I'm going to add in the spice mixture. And then to that, I want to grind in a little fresh ground nutmeg. Just a couple swipes of fresh ground nutmeg. I'll put in a generous amount of fresh ground black pepper. And the sausage is generally very highly seasoned. It's takes very well and holds up very well to all different types of very predominant spices. I'll give it a good mix. And the reason why I was able to put the egg directly in there instead of beating it before, because I'm doing a really good mix with my hands. So for a pound and a half of lamb, one egg is actually very fine for the binding. So for the sausage, these are going to be sausage patties. So what I want to do is shape them into a round or even an oval shape. There's no need to have like a casing on the meat. But we just try and make them all equal in size. This way they're all going to cook exactly at the same time. Now a good idea is to make the sausage patties up ahead, at least an hour or two ahead, and put them in the fridge. You most certainly can make them up the night before. Again, if you're able to make them up ahead, the patties will be much more highly seasoned. It'll have a chance for the meat to pick up all the flavor of the seasoning. Okay, let's take the sausage patties, put them in the fridge for about 2 hours, and then we'll come back and fry them off. Okay, my patties are well chilled. And since the patties are well chilled, I also want to make sure my fry pan, my large saute pan, is also very, very hot, especially in the beginning. I want the meat to kind of sizzle and sear when they hit the pan. I want a nice crust on the bottom of the sausage patties. So again, we can test it by just putting a little piece in there, and then if you hear a sizzle and you see a sizzle, then you know it's ready to start. So we'll start them on a high heat, and I'll put them in, going all in the same direction. This way I'll know which way to turn them when it's ready. So now the sausage patties are sizzling up. It's a good time to start my Johnnycake recipe. It's very easy because it's only really four ingredients. It's a very old American type recipe. You know, you think a regular pancake is, but we can take claim of Johnnycakes because it's made from fine ground cornmeal. And to that, I'm going to add in a teaspoon of salt, a tablespoon of sugar, and then up to about 1¾ cups of milk. I say up to 1¾ cups of milk because it is slightly variable depending upon sometimes the cornmeal. And also the humidity in the air might affect it by a tablespoon or so. So we want to make it into a very thick batter. that we'll put on a 375 degree griddle. And make it a little thinner. Okay, we'll let the batter sit a moment. And we'll just check back on our sausages to see how they're doing. And I'll just check the first one. Lightly flip it over and it's nicely brown. You see, again, the key to the sausage patty is really just making them ahead and then letting them chill. The two benefits is they hold together nicely. And the second benefit is the seasoning becomes so much more pronounced in the patty. And of course the most common sausage and breakfast sausage is a pork sausage. But I think lamb, especially when you're serving brunch, kind of changes it all up a little. Okay, good way you can check and see if it's done and if it's at a medium or medium well consistency. Just with a spatula, just take and press down lightly, and you can see the resistance, that it's popping up so much, it's telling me it's time to come off. So let's plate these up. The lamb smells absolutely incredible. And you can even keep these warm in a 150 degree oven if you had to for about 5-10 minutes while you make the Johnnycakes. Okay. Let's take the Johnnycake batter back to the grill. Now the Johnnycakes can also be cooked up in the same fry pan that you did the lamb in, and that gives it a really nice taste. It keeps it on the savory side, but I'm gonna put a little bit of a sweet spin. So you get the savory with the lamb, and you get the sweet with the griddle cake. And again, it's such a simple, easy dish. Absolutely perfect for brunch. Just a little bit of cornmeal and milk, finished with a little maple syrup. So there you have it. I've plated up the perfect brunch. Fresh squeezed mimosa, savory lamb sausage patties, and Johnnycakes with sweet country butter and maple syrup. If I can do it, you can do it. We'll see you real soon. For more on recipes, entertaining lifestyle tips, TV series blog, and selected video clips from today's show, join me at chefgeorgehirsch.com.